This is a 4-wide, tileable, expandable, accurate super stopwatch that can measure 1/10 of a second in Minecraft Pocket Edition. This is basically JL2579's design, but converted to Minecraft Pocket Edition, so credits to him. You can reset. You can start. Stop. And resume. You can turn on and off display, it's a lag reducer. This is optional, you can just remove it if you want or if you don't want it. I actually used it during the Sonic map, which I built like last year ago, including the Super Stopwatch last year ago. I didn't make a tutorial because I thought somebody would make it, but 1 year later, nobody did, so I did. This has a minimum of an input delay of 1 tick. So in demonstration, you can see it has a minimum input delay of 1 tick. This observer is outputs always a 1 tick delay. Also, this repeater can also be 2 ticks, which should produce 6. And 4 ticks, and then it would be 1 second. You can use toggleable flip-flops or T-flip-flops if you have pulse shorteners going through your machine, but it would reduce the minimum input delay or increase it by a significant amount. So I prefer to use the lever. To show you its accuracy, I made an input delay of 1 second, 4, 8, 9, 10. Each tick is 1/10 of a second, so this should produce exactly 1 second. And this is now 1.2 seconds, so it should produce a 2.2 second delay. I mean, a 2.2 second display. After placing your 7 segment displays in your preferred positions, you can now connect them through this, through the lime wool connected diagonally to the next clock with an observer over here. The observer is important as when this redstone line is on, currently on, it'll be number 9. But after it turns off, it will be 0. So it will activate the next clock through this lime wool. And so on and so forth, diagonally to the next one and to the next. This is infinitely expandable as much as you want. And the next step is to connect all the red wool with the wooden buttons to be... we're gonna connect them all, actually. So... This will be the reset circuit, which is connected to the wooden button. A wooden button is necessary because it has the right amount of delay to reset all of this. And also, this circuitry has a 1 tick delay on it, so it's gonna be a tick delay on the pistons over here. This circuitry on top of the lime wool will prevent the lime wool from activating during a reset. And this circuitry is in a tick delay. It's supposed to be 7, but since with the added repeater, it would be an 8 tick delay. I might be wrong, but you can increase the delay if you want to prevent any more issues if you want, maybe. You can remove these red wool if you want. It was... I thought it was intentional, and I thought it has a use, but I guess it didn't. Also, this will be the start and stop. Start and stop lever. You just have to connect this to anywhere else you want in your machine. Also, this will be the on and off display if you want. You can connect all of these if you want. It's optional to prevent more lag, but yeah, it's optional if you want. You can just connect this thing wherever you want if you wish. Yes, you can make it more compact, but I prefer the one with spaces because you can see the decimal point on which it will be the decimal counting